Hello crafty friends, it's Alicia of the Call Me Crafty Out YouTube channel, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you my crafty goals for 2020. I hope you'll stick around, see what they are, and see how I'm going to be keeping track. Thank you so much for stopping by today. If this is your first time to my channel, I hope that by the end of this video, you'll be inspired to click on that subscribe button below and tap on that bell for notifications. If you're already a subscriber and regular viewer, welcome back. I'm so glad that you're here. A little over a week ago, I shared a video with you where I explained how I was going to visually be keeping track of my crafty goals this year. If you're interested in hearing more about that and finding out how you can download a similar file for free, I will have that video linked below and at the end of this video in a card. I mentioned in that video that I'm going to be participating in Amalia's Crafty Goals with Amalia collab in 2020, and I am back today to tell you more specifics about my goals for the year. When I decided to participate in Amalia's collab this year, I wanted to kind of have a focus for the entire year and break that down into smaller parts that I could create monthly goals with. My overall goal this year is to craft more, spend less, share the love, and grow. And there are ways that I'm going to be doing that. For craft more, I want to make cards, non-cards, and items with my silhouette and just get more crafty this year. On spending less, I want to spend less than $50 a month on new crafty items, and most importantly, I want to use what I have. I really hope that this $50 is not something I do every month. I would like to spend a lot less, but I know that sometimes I need a stamp set or need a new die, so I do want to give myself a little wiggle room and not say something like no crafty spending. Because when I put that kind of thought in my brain, all I want to do is buy crafty stuff. Let me know below if you're with me on that. For share the love, I want to send out the cards I make and leave more love for others who share their creations online. Every year I make tons of cards because you know when I make a sheet load, I'm making 8 to 12. And even when I just come down here and craft non-sheet load, I always seem to make an abundance of cards. I very rarely just make one or two cards in a sitting. And all they do is just sit here in my craft room, not collecting dust because I do have them in boxes, but they don't go anywhere. So this year, I want to start sending those and giving those cards out. This is by sending cards to family, friends, and even subscribers. So if you have ever sent me anything to my PO box, my goal this year is to start sending you a little card back. Not only do I want to share the love by sending cards out, I also want to share the love online by leaving comments, whether it's on YouTube, Instagram, a blog. I just want to be more positive and tell people how much I appreciate seeing their creations and getting inspiration from them. For the and grow, this is mainly growing my presence here online, whether it's through YouTube or Instagram. I'm going to aim to get more subscribers on YouTube and more followers on Instagram. Now, this is where you could help me just a little bit if you want. If you're not already subscribed to me on Instagram, I am at CallMeCraftyOw. I would love it if you would go over there and become a follower. Now, let's get a little bit more specific. Every month, I have monthly goals, and then I also have some yearly goals, things that I don't think will happen every month, or things that I want to do and have an end goal at the end of the year. So now I'll tell you a little bit more about those. I again have made myself a little crafty tracker here. Each month I will have a sheet for the month and it lists the goals that I want to complete. If there is ever a goal that I will only have for 1 month, I do have some blank spaces down here to write those in. And again, these goals should help me focus on my overall goal of craft more, spend less, share the love, and grow. Every month, I want to make 2 sheet loads of cards. As you know, those are usually 8 to 12 cards each. I always share 1 sheet load at the first of the month when I debut the new file for the month, but now I want to make sure that each month I make at least 1 more. I want to use my silhouette at least 1 time per month. I have that wonderful piece of equipment and very rarely use it. I would like to color on at least 1 card. I am not a huge fan of very detailed colored cards, But whenever I do color an image, I always love it. So I would love to do that more, whether it's getting out my real brush markers or my colored pencils. Going with the use what I have, I want to use an old stamp set. Those would be probably ones that I've kept in my closet and they've been there for a couple years. I want to use an old embellishment or tool, maybe some brads or eyelets, maybe get out my decorative scissors, things that have been sitting around unloved for a while. I want to limit my crafty spending to $50 a month like we talked about. I want to send 2 cards to a family member. I want to send or give 2 cards to friends or coworkers. And I want to have a goal of sending 2 cards to subscribers. I would like to continue doing the monthly 4 on Friday collab with my friend Danny. It has been so much fun and I've loved doing it together with her. I participate on YouTube and she participates on her blog. I do have the playlist linked below if you want to check that out. Every month I want to participate in the Crafty Goals collab, which this is what I'm telling you about right now. I want to do it the whole year. I do want to follow through. I want to create and share a sheetload of cards file every month. I know last year once I started it, I did have to skip a month or two. I'm going to try my best to be here every month with one of those. I have already done that, so I colored it in. I want to leave love on at least 20 YouTube videos, leave love on at least 10 Instagram posts, and leave love on at least 5 blog posts. To show you how much I appreciate when you leave me love, I want to reply to all my YouTube and Instagram comments. Even if it's just something simple and quick, I do like to let you know that I am seeing what you're saying to me. And overall, every month, I would like to post at least 8 YouTube videos. Some months for me, that is no problem. And then other months, it's a fight to get 2 out. So I would just like to be more consistent. Now, this month in January, I do have 1 goal for just this month, and that is to organize my Gina K inks. For Christmas, I got all 5 of her ink spot collections, and I don't want to keep them in these or have 5 different packages, so I'm trying to think of a way where I can get them all in maybe 1 container or 2 at the most. If you have any ideas, let me know below. Now, I do also have some yearly goals, and some of these might be met before December, and if they are, I will take note. My first yearly goal is to do 4 live videos on YouTube. I just think this might be fun and more interactive, so I'm gonna try to do 4. I will say each month how many I completed that month and then give you my total for the year. I would love to reach 12,000 subscribers on YouTube. As of today, when I am filming this video, which is January 1st, I have 8,160. So each month I will let you know the new total. My next thing is I want to get 2 months ahead on my sheet load file and do a call for collaborators. I love seeing your Instagram posts and your blog posts and your videos using the sheet load. And I would like to do something a little more organized, kind of have like a design team, just to get the word out there more, because I know when people find it, they really do seem to love it. And finally, for my yearly, I would like to reach 800 followers on Instagram. You might be like, 800? That's not much. Currently, as of January 1st, I'm at 466, so that is almost doubling it. I really don't know if this is one of the goals that I'll reach, but I am going to try. If you would be interested in helping me reach the 12,000 subscribers goal or 800 followers on Instagram, I would love it if you would share about my channel, and if you're not already a follower of mine on Instagram, I would love it if you would go there and follow me. My name there is @callmecraftyal. I almost forgot to share with you the visual tracker that I'll also be using each month. I talked about this on my January 3rd video, and I also let you know how you can download the file for yourself if you want to. I have that video linked below, and it will be at the end of this video on a card. But each month, what I'm going to do when I have received a card or gave a card or used an old stamp, I'm going to use the corresponding color and color in one of the hexagons that's at the top. And then at the end of the month, I'm hoping that I will have a very colorful page to share with you. I'm really looking forward to coming back each month and sharing my updates, how I am doing. We will be back the first Saturday of every month at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to share our goals. Now that you've heard about my goals, I hope you will go check out all of the other collaborators. You can click on the hashtag #CraftyGoals with Amalia, or you can check out my description box for links how you can go see everyone's videos. If you enjoyed this video, as always, I appreciate a thumbs up. Until my next video, I hope you're having a crafty day. Bye-bye.